Let's see, where was I? I was doing a math problem. What was that math problem about? Do you remember? Of course you remember. We were doing a math problem about me giving you money to watch these lessons. Specifically, we were counting the number of ways I could give out this stack of dollar bills to you and everyone else who's watching this lesson today. And that turned out to be a pretty hard problem. There are a lot of dollar bills here, and there are a whole lot of you watching this lesson. So first we tried some casework, and that didn't work too well because it was just way too complicated with so many dollar bills and so many of you. So what we did is we tried simpler problems, tried considering less money. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten about the rest of it. We tried giving out less money to fewer students, and we counted the number of ways to do it in all these different cases. We came up with this table here for the number of ways to give out different amounts of money to different numbers of students. And we saw a familiar pattern. 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 4, 6, 4, and there'll be a 1 there, 1, 5, 10, 10, there'll be a 5, and then a 1. It's Pascal's triangle. And yeah, there's a whole lot of space up here, so you know we have some more work to do. And also, you should be wondering at this point, hockey stick identity. These lessons are called the hockey stick identity. Where's the hockey stick? Well, we'll get to that. We'll get to that in just a minute. Put my money away. What's that? Oh, you want to make sure I don't forget about the money. Okay, that's fair enough. I will put the money right up here on the board. Right there, so we won't forget about the money. And now, back to the hockey stick. Do you see it? I don't see a hockey stick either. Let's go back to our giving money to you problem and see if we can find the hockey stick. Well, how do we get the numbers in this grid? We worked out a few cases, but then we saw that we could add the numbers in each row to get the numbers in the next row. For example, 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is 10. 1 plus 3 is 4, 1 plus 3 plus 6 is 10, 1 plus 3 plus 6 plus 10 is 20, and so on. We can build the whole table just by adding up each row to get the next row. That's interesting. So we have this neat pattern in this table. And since this table is the same thing as Pascal's triangle, when we find a neat pattern in the table, we've found a neat pattern in Pascal's triangle. Specifically, when we're adding up a row here, that's the same as adding a diagonal over here, because the diagonals of Pascal's triangle are the same as the rows of this table. All the ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 3, 6, 10, 15, 21. 1, 3, 6, 10, 15. That next number will be 21. So when we add up a row here, we're just adding up a diagonal there. So when we add up this row and get a number in the next row, well, that tells us we can add up a diagonal here and get a number in the next diagonal. So we can test this out a little bit. 1 plus 3 plus 6 is 10. 1 plus 4 is 5. 1 plus 4 plus 10 is 15. And we can add the other way too. You know, because the diagonals going this way are the same as the diagonals going this way. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6. 1 plus 3 plus 6 plus 10 is 20. Let's take a closer look at that last one. All right, we're going to circle the row, the diagonal that is, the diagonal that we just added up. It's the same as a row over here. When we add this diagonal up, add these four numbers together, we get a number in the next diagonal and down on the next row. And there it is. We'll circle that in blue. And there's the hockey stick. Now you have to look closely. I mean, here's the handle. Here's the blade of the hockey stick. Okay, we're kind of stretching it a little bit, but we have to give it a name. We're not going to call it the add a bunch of number on the diagonal of Pascal's triangle and get a number in the next diagonal identity. Yuck. You certainly don't want to write that over and over. Hockey stick identity. Now you can see it. There's the handle. There's the stick. There's the hockey stick identity. But what is the hockey stick identity? Right now it's just a pattern in Pascal's triangle. And well, Pascal's triangle, it's all combinations. So whenever we have a pattern in Pascal's triangle, What we really have is a relationship among combinations. And that's what you're going to find out. We're going to put that up here in the next lesson, but you're going to try to find it on your own. What is the relationship among combinations that we found here? So what I want you to try to do is you're going to try to create your own identity, the hockey stick identity, basically a formula that'll always work for combinations. So you're going to try that out, and then we are going to fill that out up here.